Hello guys, what we see here is a Marantz power amplifier, the MM9000. Look closer. MM9000, yes, with the EV9000. This is a set, yes, I bought it as a set. And the this CD I bought separate, the CD6000 OSE Special Edition, my friends. Special. And, well, the thing is, what's this? Simon opened the hood. He's opened the hood for me. What's this? This is an impressive insight. So when you see the inside, yeah, this impressive insight. Okay, it's not a toroidal travo. We have here the travo, but it is a preamplifier, I guess, my friends. And you would think, wow, this thing has to sound very good, but that's the problem. The thing sounds bad. And the problem is the preamplifier. So later, we're going to use a Marantz preamplifier, and we're going to use only the tuner from this thing. Yes, because the tuner is nice, only the preamplifier is worthless, you know. And I think I'm going to sell this piece, I'm going to keep these two, you know. But the strange thing, they all have the same color, the same coat, but if you watch closely, you see that it looks like a different color. The upper two, so this is a set, this one and this one, the same color, this is a set. But it doesn't look like a set, huh? No, it doesn't look like a set at all. But it's all gold, you know, gold version. These two looks like a set, you know, CD and DP. But the main amp is a power beast. And I'm curious how this thing sounds. Simon said it sounds okay. He earlier tested it in his house with the Marantz preamp. And I'm curious how it sounds, but I already know it cannot beat my Akai, but yeah, you never know, we're gonna try. And this is how it sounds. Well, let me right away, why not tuner, this is the tuner, it's the selector switch over here. Very fine tuner, smooth geo tuning. This knob works even better than the old Marantzes, than the vintage Marantzes. But well, I don't. Good reception, my friends. Very good receptions. Well, I'm going to switch over to AUX. AUX, what it was, eh?
Yes.
CD1.
The one behind the tuner.
AUX, yes. This one. Okay, I'm going over to my phone to let you hear the shitty sound, because it is a shitty sound, my friends, and I'm so, well, I'm not very happy with this. I thought that it is, you know. I thought, well, this monster had to sound good, you know. know, but it sounds like a tin can. Well, the combination, the preamp in combination with this monster amp, you know? Okay, you know what we're going to do? I don't like this sound, and we're going to try this Marantz preamplifier, and we come back when we connected it, okay? And we're going to use this thing as a tuner, you know, only tuner, not preamp. We're going to use the Marantz preamp as the real preamp, because this thing doesn't sound, it sounds like cheap, you know, incredible cheap. We tried everything, you know. This sound is bad. This sound is not bad. It sounds like an amp from 10 euro. 10 euro, my friends. This is how it sounds on this thing, you know. But I thought so much of it because look how beautiful it is. That's what I say. Looks can be deceiving. You know, sometimes when you see a nice car, you know. You're gonna drive in that car, the drive lousy, you know. And same is with this thing. This combination is bullshit, you know, real bullshit. That's why I'm going to sell it quick. And this is still the best. But yeah, I don't want it, my friends. I don't want it. But it sounds good. And now we're gonna try the Accuphase A202. And to see if the Accuphase over here on the floor, on the floor over here, if this Accuphase can beat the Amcons, because until now, for these speakers, these ohm speakers, those 2. And they dip until 2.5 ohm. That's the problem. Normal speakers, my Akai would be satisfied, you know, more than enough, beautiful sound. But because these speakers dips, you know, the speakers over there, the ohms, dips under the 2.5 ohm. You need special, very good amplifiers, very balanced amplifiers, stable amplifiers. And these Amcons are very stable, Amcon crown amplifiers. But, okay, we're gonna try the Accuphase now, okay? Well, guys, the movie goes on, and we tested a Marantz preamplifier, the original AV9000. Disaster, my friends. We tested a vintage preamplifier with the MM900. Disaster, my friends. We tested the Amcron SP PSL2. With that combination, very good sound, big improvement, but the overall winner in this test is the 1975 Accuphase E202, my friends, and I didn't expect that, because these speakers are special speakers dipping to 2.5 ohm sometimes. So I didn't expect that Accuphase, this E202, could handle that better as the Amcron. But that's the fact, my friends. Listen to this. You and your friend, yeah? Offset, you had enough proof. You heard how beautiful that sound is, and these ohms are very, these ohms, if you have a normal speakers, you don't hear the difference very fast, but with these speakers, you know, you, if you doubt one amp, you know, which one is better, you're not sure. With these speakers, you know immediately which amp is the better one, because they are very sensitive. Well, you heard the difference so clear with the different amps. We tested 4 amps. We tested 4 amp. We tested 4. Well, we tested 1 preamp, 2 preamps on the MM9000, and the older vintage Marantz preamp was better as the original preamp with the set, the AV9000. You know, that sound was terrible, but the vintage Marantz also didn't sound that strong and nice. And then we connected the Amkron, only the preamp on that MM9000. That was a big improvement. And then we had a little extra improvement when we used that Amkron main amplifier. And then we connected this Accuphase E202, and that was the overall winner today. So this was the video, just playing to see which amp works best on my new ohm speakers, my beautiful ohm speakers, my friends. What's the yeah. And I'm the only one, I'm the proud and the only one who can say I have ohm speakers in my house in the Netherlands, because I'm 100% convinced that I am the only person in the Netherlands who have these speakers, my friends. So, I know you are a little bit jealous now, but yeah, this is life. This is life, you know. This is life. But, if you are so jealous, you can buy them from me, of course. You know, for the right price, everything is for sale. You know, I'm not a greedy person. Wants to keep everything for myself. I have enough speakers. If you are really interested in these speakers, just contact me, you know. And but I don't ship them away. You have to come and pick them up, you know, like a real audio film. Okay, well, thanks for watching. Put those thumbs up, and now I say bye bye.